Myself, Dr. Lingraju, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Government First Grade College, Tumkur. Today, I am going to discuss diffraction at a straight edge. So, this is under the chapter diffraction in the fourth sem of the subject physics in BSc. Diffraction at a straight edge. Look at this diagram. In this diagram, let us see S, this is O, O dash, O dash, this is E, A, B, and look here X, Y, T, C, Q, and the distance A, B, all these things. So, let us discuss about this figure. Let me describe this figure. S is a narrow rectangular vertical slit. So look here, this S, it is narrow rectangular vertical slit illuminated by monochromatic light. It means a monochromatic light of wavelength lambda. Monochromatic means single colored light. In specific, it has only one wavelength. Such light is illuminated on this rectangular slit. OE, look at this, OE is the straight edge. Look here, this is the straight edge. O and S, look here, O and S, this thing, are parallel and perpendicular to the plane of the figure. XY is the screen placed at a distance of D from the straight edge. Look at this screen, XY at a distance of B. Look at the figure 1. Here, the distance of the screen from the edge, it is B. And of course, A and B are distances. Above C, on the screen, look at this diagram. Above C on the screen, that is in the portion of C and X, CX, is the illuminated portion, and below C should be the darkness. Look here, below this C on the screen should be darkness or shadow. This is called shadow region. But it will be seen that in CX, that is the upper part, illuminated region, a new unequally spaced diffraction fringes close to C and CY, region of darkness. Some illuminations can be observed. Diffraction fringes in the illuminated region. The intensity at any point P at a distance Y from C, where C is the center of the screen, is due to the entire upper half of the wavefront AB above O dash, and the effect of the exposed portion of the lower half. The amplitude at P due to the entire upper half of the wavefront is equal to R1 by 2. If the exposed portion O dash O of the lower half wavefront contains an half period strip, the amplitude at P is equal to R1 by 2 plus R1. Look here, here it is half R1, here it is 1 R1, it is 3 R1 by 2. This is maximum. If the exposed portion O dash O of the lower half wavefront contains two half period strips, the amplitude at P is equal to 2 times P, that is equal to R1 by 2 plus R1 minus R2, that is equal to 3 R1 by 2 minus R2. This is minimum. Hence, we get maximum at P if the lower half wavefront exposes 3, 5, 7, etc. that is odd number cell. Off period strips and minimum at P if it contains even number of off period strips. As we move from C in the illuminated region, we get alternate maxima and minima, forming diffraction regions parallel to the edge of the obstacle. The amplitudes, and hence amplitude means the maximum displacement, and hence the intensities of maxima keep on decreasing and those of minima goes on increasing as we move away from C in the illuminated region. Next scene. When we move sufficiently away from C in the illuminated region, the lower off wavefront exposes all the effective off period strips and the resultant amplitude at P is equal to R1 by 2, R1 by 2 means half R, half R, half plus half it is 1 R1. So that is the intensity is equal to that of the completely exposed wavefront, and beyond the diffraction fringes there will be uniform illumination. The path difference between the wave starting from O and O dash, two waves starting from O, the point O and point O dash, and reaching P is, this is the path difference, PO minus PO dash. If this is odd multiple of lambda by 2, P will be maximum. And if this is even multiple of lambda by 2, intensity at P will be minimum. Thus, if PO minus PO dash, so this is the path difference. If this path difference is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, then P will be maximum. And if PO minus PO dash, this path difference is equal to 2n lambda by 2, 2 gets cancelled, therefore n lambda, that is equal to n lambda, P will be minimum. This is the condition for minimum. So of course here this n, yeah, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc, etc. Let SO is equal to A, that is the distance of the slit from this source, that is rectangular slit, is equal to A. SO, that is the distance of the slit from the edge, that is equal to A. OC, that is equal to B, that is the distance between the edge and the screen, and CP, that is equal to Y, that is the point on the screen from the center of the screen. So of course P is the point, any point. Now PO is equal to square root of OC square plus CP square. This is from the diagram. So here we know OC. OC is nothing but B. Therefore, in the place of OC, it is B, B square. And here CP, CP is equal to Y. Therefore, CP square is Y square. And this square root, this is the square root. Take this B square outside. We get B into 1 plus Y square by B square whole to the power of half. Okay. So this can be approximately written as B into 1 plus Y square by B square. So that is equal to B plus Y square by 2B, because B into 1 it is B, and here it is B into square, this square and B get cancelled, Y square by B, Y square by 2B it comes. Okay. So now, let this equation be, equation be 1. PO dash is equal to SP minus SO dash. that is equal to square root of SSC square plus CP square minus SO dash. So that is equal to, we know SSC is nothing but A, CP, SC is nothing but A plus B, and CP it is Y, this is on the screen, minus SO, this is the distance of the edge from the source, it is A. So this A plus B whole square, take this outside, and we get 1 plus Y square by A plus B square whole to the power of half minus A. That is equal to A plus B into 1 plus Y square by 2 A plus B whole square minus A. That is equal to B plus Y square by 2 into A plus B. Take this as equation 2. Hence, PO minus PO dash is equal to Y square by 2B minus Y square by 2 into A plus B. That is equal to AY square plus BY square minus BY square divided by 2B into A plus B. That is equal to AY square. Look here, BY square get cancelled. The remaining thing is AY square. Therefore, AY square divided by 2B into A plus B. Take this as equation 3. The condition for minimum is given by AY square divided by 2B into A plus B. That is equal to 2N plus 1 lambda by 2. Y square is equal to 2B into, cross multiply the above, in the above equation we get 2b into a plus b into 2n plus 1 lambda divided by 2a. Therefore, yn is equal to square root of b into a plus b divided by a into 2n plus 1 into lambda. Take this as equation 4. This gives the distance of the nth maximum from the center C. The condition for minimum is given by AY square by 2B into A plus B, that is equal to N lambda. YN, that is distance of nth point in the screen, is equal to square root of 2B into A plus B divided by A into N lambda. Take this as equation 5. This gives the distance of the nth minimum from the center C. From 4 and 5, we see that the distance between successive maxima and successive minima go on decreasing. This means that the spacing between successive bright and dark fringes decreases as the order increases. Intensity at the edge of the geometrical shadow. The pole of the wavefront with respect to C is O. The wavefront is divided into half period strips with respect to C. As the lower half of the wavefront is completely blocked by the obstacle, the intensity at C is entirely due to the upper half of wavefront OA. The resultant amplitude at C is R1 by 2 and intensity at C is R1 square by 4. It is 1/4 of the intensity of the entire wavefront were to be exposed. Intensity within the geometrical shadow. Let Q be a point within the geometrical shadow. The pole of the wavefront with respect to Q is Q1. The lower half of the wavefront OB is completely blocked, and the portion O1O of the upper half is also blocked. Hence, the intensity at Q is due to only the upper portion OA of the wavefront. Let the wavefront be divided into half period strips with respect to Q. If Q is such that O1 O cuts off only the first half period strip, the amplitude at Q is equal to R2 minus R3 plus R4 minus R5 plus etc. etc. That is equal to R2 by 2. As Q moves away into the geometrical shadow, first 2, 3, 4, etc. half period strips are successively blocked so that the amplitude becomes R3 divided by 2, R4 divided by 2, R5 divided by 2, etc. Hence, intensity decreases rapidly at first and then slowly as you move from C inside the geometrical shadow. The distribution of intensity is shown in figure. Look here, along x axis I is taken, that is intensity. Along y axis, look here, this is C. After this C, it is illuminated region. Before it, it is the geometrical shadow. In the x axis, look here, 0.25 I naught, and it is 0.5 I naught, like this. So look here, the graph is like this. The first one, look here, maximum, minimum, maximum, minimum, maximum, minimum, we are seeing. Alternative maximum and minimum regions are there. And look here, in this diagram, the space between the maximum and maximum is decreasing as the order is increasing. And here, the average intensity of all these bright fringes is I naught. It is I naught. They have the average intensity. It is like this. So this is the graph of distribution of intensity of fringes in diffraction pattern. This diffraction pattern is due to straight edge. And of course here, the incident light is monochromatic. Okay, thank you. And I have referred these books. So, first two books and also other books are written by our colleagues in different universities. So, thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video.